The reality is that companies need to make sales to survive. If they don't make sales, they will not earn anything, they will not have money for expansions, to pay their creditors, or even reward their shareholders. They will simply end up bankrupt. So if you have ever considered starting your own business, then you need to know the ability to sell. For that reason, today I'm going to give you the 3 best tips from the book Sell or Be Sold by Grant Cardone. Hey guys, hope you're doing great. Today we're going to talk about the art of selling. This is a topic that is unfortunately, in my opinion, not taught in school. Some might argue that this ability shouldn't really be taught in front of students because, you know, not everyone will end up becoming a salesperson. That is true, but by reading this book, you really learn that the ability to sell is really necessary for everyone who wants to thrive in today's world. The author of this book, Grant Cardone, has named the first chapter of this book, Selling, A Way of Life. This is due to that the actual definition of selling is the act of persuading or influencing another to a course of action. So this means that if you're debating and trying to win an argument, you are actually selling, or if you're writing an application, you're trying to sell yourself. Point is that selling is everywhere and you are eventually going to use it. That is why the question of today's video is how to become a better salesperson. As I said in the intro, I found 3 tips from the book Sell or Be Sold, and I'm going to serve them to you right now. The first tip has gotten the name Believe in Your Product. You have to be so sure that this product is amazing that if the customer doesn't end up buying it, you feel sorry for him. Let me tell you why you have to convince yourself that your product is a must buy, or in terms of selling yourself, that you're the right person for the job. This is because that this belief is going to reflect upon the action that you're going to take. Your beliefs shape your actions, which is going to help you to go for the extra mile in terms of getting the sales. This means, for instance, that instead of only doing 10 phone calls in a day, you're going to do 40. Another example could be that instead of only spending like an hour to two on your application, you're going to spend the whole day. You know that your product, which could be yourself, is the best, and therefore it is going to sell. Also, by believing in the product, you must also know the good points behind it, so why not completely sell it on them? On the other hand, it is really important to mention that there is a fine line between being arrogant and believing in yourself. If you're arrogant, you're probably going to underestimate the competition in the market. This is due to that if you keep believing that your product is the best over a lifetime of events where new technology has arrived and it is now possible to create a better and more functional product, then you're not gonna thrive in the competition. Consequently, try to be a bit critical for the product, of course not in front of the customer, but when you're alone, try to make it even better. The second tip is about credibility. Grant Cardone describes credibility as one of the most valuable assets that you have as a salesperson. The reason is that credibility has such a huge impact on the customer's buying behavior. To be more precise, when something happens that questions your credibility, then it becomes much more difficult for the buyer to make his decision. Like, assume a situation where the buyer doesn't trust a word of what you're saying, not even your name. Do you think the buyer is going to buy your product? Personally, I don't think so. Another example could be like that if you were at a job interview and the only thing that you did was to brag about yourself and the qualities that you have, but the employers didn't trust you and he also thought that the only reason why you applied for the job in the first place was because of the money, then you're probably not gonna get the job. So what are you going to do if something like this happens? Well, you have to provide documentation that supports your argument. If you got the cheapest product in the market, then show the customer a report or graph that indicates this. Another example could be like that if you got the best mark in a test, then find your diploma and show it. They will trust you since the things that you're rambling about are legitimate facts. A good tip though is to always use third-party materials because they are more trustworthy. The third tip is that price is never the solution, services. Okay, just to make clear, I couldn't really see how we could relate this tip to selling ourselves. However, I've still taken this with me today due to most people who are struggling to sell their products blame the fact that their prices are too high. For that reason, customers are not gonna buy their product. The reality is that this is not true at all. If it was true, then there wouldn't be a need for salespeople. What matters is primarily the service that you provide for the customer, the approach that you have, the smile on your face that makes the customer buy the product. A buyer will always pay more for great service, convenience, and being made special. Thus, forget about changing the price. It might be too high now because it doesn't reflect your service. However, just see it as a goal that you must reach. The way you can increase the quality of your service is by videotaping yourself and perfecting your craft. Watch your gestures, your hand motion, and the emotional response. Practice is what makes you confident, so do a lot of that. That's the 3 tips, guys. I hope that you have now gotten a broader knowledge in terms of selling and why it's really important to master. But also more importantly, that you have gotten the answer of today's video, which is how to become a better salesperson. If you look at the 3 tips in total, then it really comes down to being confident. You know, it's about believing in the product and your ability to sell it with credibility, as well as deliver a great service to the customer. If you do this properly, the customer is going to experience a situation that the person is not gonna forget in a long time. Hence, start practicing your technique, and I believe that you can get your way in business and life. If you are interested in getting this book, there is a link in the description. With that said, guys, leave a like or subscribe if you like this video. Have an amazing day. See you next time.